I hope this is live streaming, but if it's not, oh well. I'm just now starting out playing this game, and y'all are getting to watch it first. I just gotta figure out a name first. There we go. All right. So, don't really have much. I just accepted all my stuff already. I tried to play a game and was completely hosed by a kid who put me in a duo. Didn't know, and he whooped my behind. I mean, completely whooped. I mean, it was devastating. I got some little trinkets.
Terrence Howard singing.
Go on.
Guess that was it. Had to do something in third person, I guess.
Welcomes you to Guitar Lessons for Heroes, an evening dedicated to raising funds for high impact veteran charities, presented by the Independent Fund. Featuring Billy Gibbons, Sam Moore,
John Rudy, Lindsay L., Dave Navarro, Richie Sambora, and Orion B., and your host, Trace Atkins.
Yeah, when we're speaking of something so dramatic as bringing stability to, an entire group that
they are here at the museum, and we plan on finding them, believe it or not.
And here it is, believe it or not, Robert Ripley.
The name Robert Ripley has become synonymous with the extraordinary since the 1920s. He's been known to
take
the world as
now.
An author, illustrator, and host of Ripley.
Believe it or not.
In 1933, Ripley opened his first auditorium, and today several of these museums showcase some of the obscure items he collected during his expeditions to the far reaches of the globe. One in particular lies within the heart of Los Angeles, where we've been called to meet with the manager to help identify the source of the hauntings, which are affecting several members of his staff.
Hey, Corey. How
are
you doing?
Very good to meet you. Corey Dacey has overseen the operations of this auditorium since 2015. After I started doing a little preliminary research, I am a little concerned that some of the artifacts that you do have could be cursed. Tell me a little bit about this.
Mummy's foot, this mummy here, and that it's dated back to 2000 BC.
So we have a body part from an Egyptian mummy. This could be very powerful in the effects of what's going on here right now. The curse of the pharaohs refers to the belief that anyone who dared to disturb the tomb of an ancient Egyptian, or worse, remove part of their mummified remains, were said to have been met with the wrath of a curse so powerful it would lead to grave misfortune and, in some cases, even death. Is it true that some of your employees are really terrified?
It is. They don't have to close by themselves because of the things they can't happen to in reality. Here were from a young lady named Trinidad. She was a former employee. When she would come through this area, she said that as she went to the kids cross, something touched her butt. Underneath here is a skull in a box, too. So there's a skull in there.
Yeah. Whoa, wait a minute. Aaron!
Yeah?
Come here.
Why do I gotta go, too? I don't want to ask her.
Where's the skull?
Oh my god, there's a human skull in there?
Are you kidding?
That's crazy.
That's crazy. That makes sense why people get touched down there.
I do not. I'm so claustrophobic. You both need to block in my way, and I don't like it.
I'm kind of stuck here.
It's not funny, and I can even exit this small space, please. I'm serious, Aaron. I'm gonna panic. As we're beginning to piece together what kinds of objects are drawing the dark energy to this location,
of human remains. My hazmat skull? Let me just read you this. This skull was collected by Ripley himself in the 1920s. Hazmat are a famous cannibalistic tribe.
Really loud, and I heard No.
I want you to hear something that was happening. I want you to tell me whether or not this is what you heard.
0.5.4.3.
The unsettling parallels drawn between our evidence and Cotty's own experience here prompts her to reveal to us a disturbing, reoccurring dream, which is having a serious effect on her, and she needs our help.
I would have dreams that, I would go to a cave and suddenly conjure the feel the people screaming, I can't do anything, I can't help.
Would you believe that the people in this cave would be from some type of tribe or something?
Yes.
You're working at a place that then you wake up and whatever gave you that nightmare is embedded in you. Then it gives you a place for where it's from so that you can witness all the pain, suffering, and all the people that have been killed in this cave. We're an object. What I just said, this is a plot for the movie. But, believe it or not, it's really happening. And it's happening right here at Ripley's. And you're at the center of it. This actually inspires me. This is a charged object.
Brought to you by Liberty Mutual Insurance. Liberty Mutual customizes your coverage so you only pay for what you need.
Whoa.